And because so many people have been coming to Henryville wanting to help, wanting to show their muscle and help move some trees or clean up the personal items that are strewn across the yards, Indiana's trying to come up with a better way to centralize the volunteers and to get them going out in different directions so they really can help. WLKY's Gary Parker is here to tell us all about it.
Volunteer Joe Autry knocks door-to-door in Henryville. It's part of a new organized effort by the Red Cross and United Way. They are hoping to deliver more efficient relief to tornado survivors.
What we're trying to do is just go around and get an idea of what help you may need. Metro United Way is going to have a lot of folks reaching out to them, wanting to do volunteer work and things like that. So they're going to sort of take these assessments, and then that's how they're going to divvy up the volunteer work.
The effort so far is heartwarming to folks like Dana Hurst.
Daily, every day. And for all the people that need more, it's been kind of nice for them to come by and check on us and see how we're doing.
Here in Henryville, a lot of organizations have already set up makeshift tents like this one over here with some of the items that are going to be donated to tornado victims, but some items are needed more than others.
The majority of things needed are non-personal items.
What is not needed right now, number one, is used clothing. There is not a need for used clothing here. I mean, there's enough that's already come in. They don't need any more. And that becomes very problematic because that in itself becomes a second disaster in how to manage and sort and process all that.
Those wishing to become volunteers have two options in Jeffersonville.
They can do two things. They can come over to this center at 723 Spring again, or they can go to the Metro United Way website and enter their data there about who they are, where they're located, how can they be contacted, and we'll reach out to them.
In Henryville, Gary Parker, WLKY News.